Hello everyone, today I'll be discussing about solution to the quiz questions which were given earlier from the module 1, from the module 2 as well as from module 3. Let us see first the module 1 quiz questions. The first question was, which is the technology that connects the machines and the people within a site in a small area? So when it is a small area, the technology is said to be a local area network. It is LAN. The answer is LAN. Second one was, which protocol layer uses the protocols HTTP, FTP, SMTP? Those are Hypertext Transfer Protocol, File Transfer Protocol. It is the application protocol layer. Next, third one, ARP stands for Address Resolution Protocol. Fourth one, TCP is a DASH protocol. TCP is the connection oriented protocol. As we know that here the packets or we tell that here the segments are numbered here, and they will be arrived at the, follow the same path and arrive at the destination in order. Next, network of network is known as the internet. And when a packet with the code is transmitted, it is received and processed by every machine on the network. It is said to be broadcasting. ISO stands for, it is organization, International Standard Organization. For large network, which topology is used? It is the star topology. Next, in bus topology, if the computer cable is broken, networks get down. And the data link layer takes the packet it gets from the network layer and encapsulate them into frames. As we know that at the data link layer, it is frames. At the network layer, those are said to be the datagrams or the packets. At the transport layer, with respect to the protocol used, TCP if it is used, segments if it is UDP, it is user datagrams. What is the main function of the transport layer? It is process-to-process message delivery. When a host on the network A sends a message to host on the network B, which address does the router look at? That is the logical address or the MAC address. Communication circuits that transmit the data in both directions and at the same time are operating in full duplex mode. It is said to be the full duplex mode. UDP is called connectionless because all the UDP packets are treated independently by the transport layer. So it is said to be connectionless. And transmission medium is the physical path by which message travels from sender to receiver. This is about the module 1 quiz question. No, there are 5 more. Transit time and the response time measure performance of the network. Next, which line configuration provides a dedicated link between the two devices? It is the point to point. 7 devices are arranged in a mesh topology. Dash physical channels link these devices. Considering it as a full duplex, if there are 7 devices, then there will be 7 into 6 divided by 2 number of channels in between the devices. That is 7 n into n minus 1 divided by 2. So 7 into 6 divided by 2, which is 21. A bus topology has a multi-point line configuration. An example for the full duplex is telephone. About the module 2 question, in carrier sense multiple access, if a station senses the medium before trying to use it, then the chance of collision can be reduced. In CSMA, possibility of the collision still exists because of propagation delay. A protocol in which data is transmitted without a scheduled time is the random access. The value of Kmax in the pure Aloha is 15. In CSMA series, sending station must detect a collision if the maximum propagation time is 25.6 microseconds, minimum size of the frame is dash. It is calculated, is one of the problem. It is calculated and the value is 64 bytes. With respect to considering the bandwidth as 10 Mbps, it is done. So 25.6 microsecond was the propagation time. Then the minimum size of the frame is twice that we consider 25.6 twice of it. Will be the time required, and considering the bandwidth 10 Mbps, we get it as 64 bytes. And the lower sublayer of the data link layer is responsible for multiple access. And for CSMA CD, we need a restriction on the frame size. When no collision, station receives only one signal. In CSMA, the amount of time divided into slots is known as contention window, and the field that alerts the receiver and enables it to synchronize is known as preamble. In Ethernet, both the destination and the sender addresses are of 6 byte length, and in 10BASE-5, the maximum length of the cable is 500 meters, and the fast Ethernet can transmit a data at the rate of 100 Mbps, and the flag of the start frame delimiter is 10101011. It has to be remembered. And the gigabit Ethernet is also known as 802.3Z. The address is a unicast if LSP of the first byte is 0. The maximum length of the optical fiber in 10BASE-F is 2 km. NIC stands for Network Card Interface. It is NCI or NIC. The full duplex mode of gigabit Ethernet, there is no collision. Next is about the quiz 3, which is based on the module 3. Which level is the network layer? It was given in the Google Classroom. It is the third level. Data in the network layer is transformed in the form of packets, as it was already told. Also, these are said to be datagrams. The datagram approach of the packet switching offers connection-less service. The identifier which is used in the virtual circuit network is virtual circuit identifier. Termination is not a phase of virtual circuit network. Drawback of the classful addressing is that large part of the available addresses are wasted. Which of this is not a class of IP? It is class F. Given an address, how to find the first and the last address? To find the first address, based on the prefix, it is said to be CIDR notation, which is a class interdomain routing notation. So 28 is the prefix. So to find out the first address, those 28 LSPs are 28 MSPs will be kept as it is, and the rest are made zeros, which is nothing but altogether it is a 32-bit. So from that 28, if we subtract, it is 4. So the last 4 bits are made zeros and the rest is kept as it is. So when we make the last 4 bits as zeros, we get it as 32. Last byte gets changed from 39 to 32. Similarly, to get the last address, 28 MSPs are kept as it is, rest are made ones, or the vice versa is 32 minus 20, that is 4 LSPs are made ones, which is one in the same. 28 bits are kept as it is and 4 LSPs are made ones, or it is 32 minus 28, 4 LSPs are made ones. So when we make those 4 LSPs as ones in that 39, we get it as 47. It is the last address. How do we find out the same using the network mask? To get the first address and the address with the mask, and mask to get the last address, you OR it with the NOT of the mask. Number of addresses when the prefix length is 25 is, it is 32 minus 25 will be equal to number of to find number of addresses, it is 2 power 32 minus 25. So 32 minus 25 will be 7, 2 power 7, which is 128. Next, the module 3 quiz 2, it was given in the Google Classroom. An ISP is granted a block, the block is given. ISP needs to allocate the addresses for two organizations, each with 500 addresses, two organizations with 250 addresses, three organizations each with the addresses 50. So find the number and the range of addresses. Find the range of addresses for each ISP. Here it should be 50. Block organizations and the range of unallocated addresses. That is the first problem. Let us see that. The block is given, granted a block 80.70.56.0/21. So to find out how many addresses are present, the number of addresses and the range of addresses in the ISP is, there are 2 power 32 minus 21. 2 power 32 minus 21, that is 2048 addresses. 2 power 11 addresses in the ISP. The first address is calculated by making, in that 2 power 11, we make those 21 MSPs as it is, rest are changed to zeros, or it is the last 11 bits that we make to zeros, 11 bits in the LSP. So 8 bits will be 1 byte, so 1 byte will become full zero. Then the from the LSP side, the second byte in that 3 bits are made zeros. So 56 will remain the same. So 80 point, 70 point, 56.0, as 56 has last 3 bits, however, zeros. It is 00111000 is 56. So the last address is calculated by making those 21 bits, which is a prefix, as keeping as it is. The rest 11 bits are made ones. So we get the last byte as full 255, and the second byte 56 is changed to 63. So these are the first and the last address of full ISP. Now we have to allocate these to first to two organizations with 500 addresses each. So for the first organization, number of addresses allocated is 512, which is a power of 2. So the subnet 512, it is a nearby power of 2. 500, we should not allocate addresses which are not a power of 2. It is one of the rule 3 in the subnetting. So the subnet mask is 32 minus log of 512 base 2. To the base 2, so we get it as 23 is the prefix. So using the prefix, we can find out what is the first address, what is the last address. Similarly, it was told first address is made by keeping the 23 bits as it is and making those 9 bits, 32 minus 23, those 9 bits are zeros. So the first byte LSP will be full zero. The second byte 56 will remain the same. Similarly, the last bit is making those 9 bits as ones. So the LSP first byte will become full ones, which is 255. And in the second byte, the LSP only one bit will be one because it's 9 bits. So it is 57. Similarly, for the second organization, similar way. The other way to find is just add those 256 addresses. First address is however 0, add 255 to it, we'll get it as 257, I mean it is 512, no? So you have to add 255 twice, 256 twice, so it is, once we add it will be 56.255. Next, it is 57.0 till 57.255. So altogether 512. Similarly, for the second organization, 58.0 till 58.255 will be 256 addresses. From 59.0 till 59.255 will be the 256. So together 512 addresses. Now, for the third organization, it is all 256. So for this also, we have to find the prefix. So using the prefix also, we can find the first and the last address by using the method as it was told earlier, by making the prefix length MSPs keeping as it is, making the other LSP bits 32 minus those prefix length bits as zeros, we get the first address, and the last address we get by making those prefix length as it is, the remaining ones. Otherwise, we have to just add those addresses to the first address, we'll get the last address. Since we know that here the address ends at 80.70.59.255, next address is 80.70.60.0. So the last address, however, we get it by adding 256. So it is 80.70.60.255. Similarly, for the fourth organization, it is done in the same way. Both the ways we can calculate. Similarly, fifth organization is 64. We have to allocate addresses. So here the prefix gets changed to 26. So similarly, first and the last address is calculated. So for the sixth organization, for the seventh organization also. Remember, the prefix length has to be changed. Thus, the total allocated range of addresses is from 0 till 191. So only 1728 addresses are allocated. The remaining 320 addresses are unused. Next, the second problem was regarding find the show this forwarding process. If the packet arrives with the destination address, it is forwarding based on the destination address. So destination address is given and the forwarding table is also shown. We have to find out the packet will be forwarded to which interface. Here one of the addresses is given with the interface and the other address is also given with the interface. One is M0 and one is M1. So here you can see that the question destination address is this one. So based on the mask which is given, there are two masks which is given. So and also the address is specified. First mask is applied to the resulting address. When we apply that first mask using the same procedure, if we get the resulting address, then in that case 192 we obtain here, which is not equal to 192, which is given in the table. Here we get it as, actually we get it as 128. Similarly, if you use mask 25 here, slash 25, that means making 25 bits as it is, rest, that is how the mask is performed, mask is applied, the resulting address will be 128, which is the given address in the routing table. We make all the remaining will be zeros. So thus the packet will be forwarded. Since those addresses match, this destination address and given destination address in the table with the interface matches, the packet will be forwarded to M1 interface as mentioned. Similarly, next question is just defining this host private multicast limited loopback address. What is this host? This host address is only address in the block is 00032. It is used whenever host needs to send a datagram, but it does not know its own address to use as the source address. Then this will be used. Private address, your organizations are assigned private address, which you have seen it in the network address translation. These are the few addresses are examples. Multicast address, the block, if we write all the bytes as 0, 224.0.0.0/4, it is reserved for multicast address. Next is the limited broadcast address. So only address in the block is 255.255.255.2/32. It is used whenever a router needs to send a datagram to all the devices, and the routers block the packet having this address as the destination. The packet cannot travel outside the network. Next is loopback address. Here this is packet with this address 127.0. This is one of the example. Here with one of the addresses, the destination address never leaves the host. It will remain there itself. Any address in the block is used to test a piece of software in the machine. We can write a client in the server program in which one of the addresses is used as a server address. We can test the programs using the same host to see if they work before running them on different computers. Next, the fourth program given in the quiz was, it was a CIDR receiver packet with the address. The routers entities are, these are the addresses with the interface M3, with the interface M1. Routing table has the following with the interface M2. The packet will be forwarded to which interface? So there are interfaces given here, M3, M1 and M2 with respect to three addresses. We have to check one by one. Similar to the process for this destination, considering this destination address, we have to mask it with the 15, 16, 14. When we mask it with the 15, if the resulting address is this one, that means it will be forwarded to that. If it is, when we mask it with 16, if we get the resulting address as given in the table, then it will be forwarded to that interface respectively. So to apply the mask, we have to make based on the mask. For example, if the mask is 15, we have to keep 15 bits as it is, rest of the bits we have to make zeros. And if we get the resultant as same as that of the routing table, then in that case that will be forwarded to that. So the first address itself matches, so the packet will be forwarded through M3 interface as mentioned in the question. So this is about all the four quiz questions which I have solved. Just go through all this, module 1, module 2, module 3. So in module 3, the subnetting, then forwarding of the IP packets related problems are very important. This is about the quiz questions. In the next subsequent Google Classrooms, module 4 quiz questions will be asked. Thank you.